the type of data that we work on is called single cell genomics. So that is basically a readout of a cell that give you multiple information of how that cell would look like at that specific time point or at a certain, under a certain disease. And what we do is we create these generative AI models that can predict what they would look like if we, you know, treat them with a certain drug that we haven't tested in the lab. This could help to narrow down the hypothesis space of drugs that could reverse disease effect and potentially accelerate drug discovery, find and curing disease. And finally, imaging too, because you can actually take a picture of these cells and then their shape and morphology will also change after disease with certain perturbations. So we show generative AI models that can predict those type of behaviors too. Coming from computer science, I can see how people are, you know, how the field have been revolutionized by use of machine learning. So a few years ago, if you would have told someone that we're using an in silico model to design drugs, they would have laughed, right? But right now, that is kind of the main tool or one of the main tools in many subfields of biology, protein structure prediction, drug design. In a few years, it would be hard to be a biologist and not to know how to use AI. We are solving interdisciplinary problems. So we need to have experts from multiple domains, and they need to find a common language to talk to each other, and then have different experts from these different domains to work together to solve challenging problems like drug discovery and curing disease. I think for us, it's going to be generating data to train these models. That is what is in many aspects missing in many fields, especially in our field. We don't have comprehensive data for many diseases. So one mission in our institute is to generate these type of data sets to then train large-scale models that are able to better capture biology. Because without the data, these models are also kind of useless. So you need to generate data in a targeted way that these models get better. And that could also help you in your discoveries and also scientific discoveries, of course, yeah.